talk about the most common mistakes I see foreigners make in Palermo. You know, those inevitable mistakes that we all do when we go to a new place, but we would love to have somebody help us to avoid them. Well, I am that somebody. I was born and raised in Palermo, and I will help you avoid 10 of them. But keep your ears open, because what I'm going to say will save you tons of time and money. Let's look at them one by one. Number one, trusting TripAdvisor. Sicilians, as they say in these parts, they have their asses heavy, which means that they are lazy bones. We don't do reviews online except to spit out a toxic sentence because of a little stain found on a fork, or our zucchini was overcooked. And consequently, TripAdvisor rankings are defined by Italian foreign tourists and not certainly by Sicilians. The result? You will not find the best places on TripAdvisor, nor on Tom, Dick, on Harry's blog, where in turn, as tourists themselves, found those restaurants on TripAdvisor too. So what's that solution? You have to ask the locals, no other options. Here everything revolves around the word of mouth. Number two. Going to the first random bar or club. Palermo is not like London or Barcelona, where you can't go wrong by picking the historic or always popular club or bar you find on Google. The nightlife in Palermo is based on a sort of stage route that is always changing based on word of mouth. The trick is to follow the right route on the right day to end up in the right places at the right time. To help you better understand, a certain bar can be packed with people on a Saturday and the next Saturday, within just a week, be completely empty or even closed. And again, a club can work well on Friday and it has no soul on Saturday. You have to follow itineraries even at night. You have to know where to go if you want to have an authentic night experience, and I assure you that blogs and TripAdvisor are not that solution. Again, we still live here by word of mouth, so ask the locals. Number three, not planning an itinerary. The historic center of Palermo is among the largest in Europe with its immense cultural heritage. Most of the attractions take time to be visited and appreciated. The ideas of I get to Palermo and then we'll see, or I'll walk around and see what I can find, although convenient, will make you miss the most important things and understand anything about the city. By the way, you don't have to swallow a history book, but you should try to learn at least the 2-3 basic steps and get audio guides, especially for outdoor monuments. Otherwise, the risk is looking at things without fully comprehending their significance. Plan a well-calculated and reasonable itinerary for the distances and time you have available. Also, find good audio guides or hire a human guide. Number four, thinking that here we eat only street food and pizza. Even though there are hot dogs everywhere in the US, that doesn't mean Americans eat only hot dogs, right? Likewise, you'll notice that the streets of Palermo are full of street food vendors and pizza vendors, but that doesn't mean we eat only street food and pizza every day from morning to night. For example, I eat street food maybe twice a year. In fact, the main portion of our diet comprises vegetables and fish. Then thank God, otherwise they would already given me a liver transplant by now. Anyway, If you want to eat like a local and not like a tourist, you have to abandon stereotypes and investigate what and where to eat. And also keep in mind that English is not common and the best restaurants in town don't have the menu in English. If you don't do your homework, you risk arriving in Palermo not knowing what to order and eating only the most advertised things. Street food, pizza, and pasta, of course. Number five, not having fully comprehensive car insurance. We always think, what could possibly happen? I'm a cautious person. And this is how rental car companies get your money in their pockets. If you don't sign for a fully comprehensive insurance, they will charge you dearly for every single scratch they find on the vehicle. And I assure you, my dear friend, that there is no way they will not find at least one scratch on your car. So trust me, get a fully comprehensive insurance policy. Sure, you spend more, but it will always be less than what they will ask you when they blame you for every single scratch they find on the car. Number six, relying completely on public transport. Palermo is not Paris or London. Public transport outside the city center is a real gamble with your destiny. You live from point A in your 20s, and by the time you get to point B, you are already in retirement age. At night, the service is even reduced to 10%. Translation? Non-existent. If you pick up accommodations outside the key areas to save some money, you will spend them on medication for a nervous breakdown, unless you have a flying carpet. And by the way, that solution is not a cab, which costs a shitload of money. So, what's the solution? Pick up your accommodations in a key area and rent a car or a scooter if you want to see the surrounding areas. Number seven, expecting to be served professionally. Generally, in places like the United States or in England, waiters smile at you, ask you how you are doing, and treat you like a prince, right? In Sicily, or in Italy in general, they all seem to be pissed off and ready to flip you off at any moment. But this because their job is simply to take orders and bring food to the table, and all for a miserable salary. Also consider that tips here are not mandatory, and voluntary ones are pathetic. To make the story short, they do a shitty job for bad pay, and there is also not a great culture in cuddling the customer, except in fancy restaurants. Number eight, assuming that everyone speaks English. This is what tourists underestimate most. They often arrive in the city without any information, thinking that they can ask the locals. Then they discover that apart from 50 basic words locals know to indicate some good restaurants, clubs, bars, or directions in general, nobody is able to converse in English. So translation, if you don't speak Italian and can't communicate well with gestures like Charlie Chaplin, finding information can be a daunting task. So what can you do to make your life easier in Italy? Try to arrive well educated about everything and just ask for basic information like directions. Number nine, visiting Palermo only in warm seasons. Sun and sea are certainly among the highlights of the city, but even a vacation in the coldest season has its advantages. And what is one of these advantages? Palermo should be discovered on foot. For example, there are hundreds of itineraries to follow and sights to see. And I assure you that walking around with the sun beating on your head is not pleasant at all. And also in the colder seasons, there are plenty of exclusive events like the Paths of Treasure. During this event, many attractions are half price and some are open exclusively during this event. And also consider that the days of rain and cold are not so many and they are concentrated in January and February. And last of all, ordering foreign wine. This is the mistake that freaks restaurant owners most. Sicilian wines and Italian wines in general are among the most award-winning in the world. Sicily is a land of red, white, and fortified wines. I mean, there are good wines all over the world, but when you are in Sicily, ordering a New Zealand or a California wine not only makes little sense, but you will also pay double because it is imported. That's it. Before we say bye-bye, I would like to tell you that I have created a guide called That Sicilian Way that helps you avoid all of these mistakes. You will be able to have an authentic local experience. Check it out if you are interested. Ciao.